child will be returned on a temporary basis to the mother.
Those were the orders that Lieutenant Colonel Vanessa Benson was waiting to hear. Orders from a Florida judge today that ended her 8-month-long custody battle for her 14-year-old son.
Since I returned from Afghanistan, I've been fighting a multi-state battle to get my son back.
Last December, Benson shipped out to serve in Afghanistan. She gave her ex-husband temporary custody of their son with the understanding John Jr. would return home once she did. That didn't happen.
I had gotten an email from my son's father that says, you need to get a lawyer. I'm not sending your son back to you.
Her ex-husband, John Collier Sr., who declined to speak with CBS News, lost his argument in court that he'd established a more stable life with his son in Florida while Benson was deployed with her Army unit.
I feel that I'm being put in the same category as an unfit mother.
Well, we need to pass this law to protect our service members.
Representative Michael Turner is trying to pass a bill in Congress that would prevent military parents' custody rights from being undermined after they've deployed overseas.
These people are not leaving their families or their children to go off to someplace to find themselves. They are serving their country.
A CBS News analysis of custody laws found only 5 states which guarantee children automatically return after deployment. 5 others prohibit deployment from being used against a service member in court. 14 have weaker provisions. The rest give no additional protections. Lieutenant Colonel Benson will bring John Jr. home to Kentucky for Christmas, reuniting him with his baby brother and stepfather.
I'm going to give him a big hug and let him know that this isn't going to affect his relationship with his dad.
She says she just wants to serve her country without sacrificing her son. Michelle Miller, CBS News, Fort Campbell, Kentucky.